in, we are done another month. We've done another month of watching anime, reading manga. Goals here. Currently sitting at 80 complete year. 881 total anime. Total that I'm aiming. So another 20 more completions. Yeah, definitely cool. So that's going to be a little bit above average for what I've done per month recently. Manga, on the other hand, the way that we've been going, I should be able to hit 248 chapters of manga read by the end of the year. So looking good in that way. Into yearly, yeah, I've done 8 completions this month. Yeah, average. Go to 8 completions, average rating of 68, which isn't too bad. My highest rating is Jellyfish in the Night, and then lowest rated is I Parry Everything, which I didn't hate, but I don't think I've really watched anything that is really, really bad. I tend not to watch it's really, really, really bad if I can help it. But anyway, yeah, my first completion month was I Parry Everything, which it was very middle of the road kind of thing. It wasn't animated well. The story was weird. I can't say weird, but it was kind of basic-ish. It did have some fun songs and stuff like that. NED were quite fun, I thought. Touchy Game was one of our NCL Watch Club shows, and I found it pretty interesting. It definitely made me want to keep watching it and keep watching it, and now I'm going through and reading the manga as well. So, it was a good recommendation. I definitely enjoyed it. It's definitely not like super top tier show or anything like that, but it definitely... definitely scratches that death game itch. I watched both seasons of Femi Can't Communicate after that. But it's enjoyable. It's just there's these kind of rom-com romance shows that I enjoy more. Nothing against Comey. Yeah, not my favorite of them all. Agretzko Season 2, once again, this is a Watch Club show. I didn't really care for Season 1, and once again, I didn't really care for Season 2. It's fine. I understand why people enjoy it. It's just not something I care for. On the other hand, Jellyfish in the Night, I thought it was very cute. And it was very pretty aesthetically. Like, animation-wise, it was nothing stood out being really poorly done or anything like that. Time that I could see, not that I necessarily am the most pay attention to that, but overall I enjoyed the show. Story-wise, it was pretty straightforward, knew what it was doing. It very follow the tropey anime-ish kind of the storyline, but it was overall enjoyable. I did not dislike it at all. Hiroko-chan, I'm not much of a horror fan, but it's still fun show, I thought. I like the art style and the animation in it and stuff like that. And even though it is horror, it is quite cute and funny at the same time. So yeah, that's why I have rated it as I did. And then I finished watching Battle Game in 5 seconds, even literally like an hour ago before I started recording this. I liked Tomodachi Game a lot more than it. The animation in Battle Game in 5 seconds is kind of not great. In some areas, yeah, it's very noticeably bad. I prefer Tomodachi Games more based in realism, not realism, really, but you know, like, not the supernatural superpowers kind of thing that Battle Game in 5 seconds has. But it was still fine. As I said, I haven't watched any really, really, real big stinkers. So, yeah, that has been my month of anime, I guess. I haven't really started watching any of the seasonals or anything like that. Then to try and... if you've watched these videos at all... that I tend to watch stuff that I can get the whole way through. I don't have to wait for anything. If I can. Sometimes there's shows that I like to watch as they're coming out, like a VTube, like that. But I like to binge, so I don't really watch the seasonals until they're all completely done. So yeah, I'll probably be looking back and seeing good shows to watch over the next month as well. So anyway, that has been my month in anime. 8 completion, bunch of manga. Yeah. That's it. More anime.